Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Arpit, and today I'm going to discuss about how to set up Dynamo 365 and Power Platform trial instance. So if you already have the licensed version of the Dynamo 365, the Power Platform environment available with you, you don't need to create the trial instance. But there are a few folks available who are jumping into the Dynamo 365. They just want to learn the new features. And someone who want to create the POCs to quickly demonstrate the capabilities of Power Platform, so they need to create the trial instance first. And in order to create our first Canvas app or start exploring the components of the Canvas app, we need to have the Dynamo 365 and Power Platform trial instance available. All right. So if you missed all the last videos, please go and check them out on my YouTube channel. And before moving ahead with the chapter 3 video, a quick introduction about myself and the learning series that I have started till now. All right. So if you have to create the Dynamo 365 or the Power Platform trial environment setup, then first you need to go to the trial instance, the trial.dynamics.com. So you can simply just Google it, Dynamics 365 trial. All right, and just click on the first link, and you will be redirected to this page. So I'm just closing this. So this is the URL through which you can just navigate it to the the trial page of the Dynamo 360 web setup. You just need to click on the sign up here and need to click on the no continue sign up. All right. This will take you to the page where you need to fill in your details. Okay, so it's asking you for your email address. All right, so make sure that you are providing your valid email address, because all the notifications and confirmation user ID and password will go to this email ID only. So I'm just giving my email ID. Click next. So it's saying like, looks like you need to create a new account. Let's get you started. Continue as a Arpit CRM consultant Gmail ID. I'll just click on the setup new account. Need to fill in my details. So you just need to fill in the details. It's just the basic details. It actually asks to set up your account. I just need to provide the business phone number. So make sure that you are providing your valid number, because all the verification code or the authentication code will go to this number only. I'm just providing the company name is Power Guide. And this is just the random selection. You can simply select 1000 plus people. It doesn't make any impact here. We'll select the country name as India. All right, and we'll click next. Once I click on next, it asks me to verify myself. So you just need to provide a valid number. That's why I told you. You can just select choose the call me option or the text me option as well. So I'll just click on the send verification code option. So this will send the verification code on my registered mobile number. 05796. Click on verify. All right, so the two previous step is done. Now I need to provide the business identity here. So here I need to select the business name. So let me select the business name, ma'am, Arpit Dynamics. So once I select that, it actually check whether this username is all the username is already there in the in the Microsoft database or not. So for example, let's say if I'm simply providing the Arpit. it will not take because someone is already might having using this account. So sorry, arpit.on.microsoft is not available. You cannot choose this domain. So you need to make sure that you are providing a unique name here, and just make sure not using any kind of special characters and all. Okay. So I'm just using the dynamic Arpit Dynamics, and I am allowed to use that because this is available for me. Just simply click on next. Now I need to provide the name. For example, I am providing a bit. I need to choose the password here. So you can choose any of the password. It's not mandatory that you are choosing any, you know, strong password or weak password, because it's just a trial instance. And it's up to you whether you are selecting this offer. I'm just deselecting it because I don't want to, you know, get the notification from the Microsoft Products and Services. And I'll just hit the sign up option. So this is just creating an account in the Microsoft database. All right. So, and it will give me the, you know, the username and the password. So it will take a couple of more seconds to set up. And you just need to make sure that, you know, unless the account setup is done, you are not refreshing or, you know, copy pasting the URL and opening it in a new tab, because it will, you know, corrupt your Dynamics 365 trial instance. So I got the confirmation that you are all set. Thanks for signing up for Dynamics 365 customer engagement plan trial. And my username is arpit@arpitdynamics.onmicrosoft.com, and I'll get the, you know, the confirmation and all the information on my registered email IDs as well. All right. So just make sure that you are copying this information so that you are not forgetting in the future. All right. Okay. Just click on get started. So as soon as I will hit the get started option, I will be redirected to the admin portal. So admin.powerplatform.microsoft.com. So this is the new feature that Microsoft recently launched, that all the you know, configurations and all the admin related settings related to that instance is going to be handled using the admin.powerplatform.com. Okay, earlier it used to be the different portals. You used to redirect on the Office 365 page, from where you need to set up the users, you need to set up the, you know, some admin settings related to the trial instance. But nowadays everything is you know, being handled using the admin.powerplatform.com. all right. So these are the questions you get in the certification exams as well. What are the things that you can manage using admin.powerappsportal.com and all. All right, so you are redirecting to this page, and here you can see there is a new pop-up is being popped up where I need to select the environment name. All right, now this is the new feature that Microsoft has recently released in the Dynamics 365, that you need to set up the environments. So instance is a different thing, and the environment is a different thing. Environment is something where you will store your data, all your configurations, and all the customization you are doing related to a particular POC or the projects. So each environment is like a instance for you. You can say like the development environments, or the testing environment, UAT environments, or the production environments, right? So if you are a developer, if you are are doing something, then you often use different instances or the environments. So same like this. Now there is a new terminology called environments. So I need to choose the environment name. So let me call this environment name is Power Guide Training. All right. And once I give the name of the environment, there is another option is what type of environment you want to create. So there are four types of instances there: sandbox, trial, production, and another trial. So obviously I'm not going to use the sandbox and the production instance, because this is for the actual purpose. I'm going to use the trial instance, obviously, because I'm setting up the trial instance. But what is the difference between the trial subscription based and the trial the normal one? What is the basic difference between this? So the basic difference is based is the type of users or the audience is going to use this particular trial. All right, not all the companies and the admin approaches trial in the same way, because this is especially true when it comes to deciding whether to allow user to try new capabilities. So some companies let users try features in a self-service manner. Other wants admin to completely control what's being tried in a particular environment and who is licensed to use the environment and all. So based on that, there are basically two types of trials: trial subscription and trial standard. Okay, so if I give you the definition is or the difference between these two, trial standard is basically a type of trial environment that companies basically use to allow users and the department managers to try new features and quickly build low code and no code application and processes. All right, so admin can enable all the users to create trial. Alright, so whoever users we are creating in this particular trial instance, they can create their own trial as well. They can create they can simply enable some new subscriptions or some new features in the particular environment. So all the users are capable to do that. But if I talk about the trial subscription base, so this is the type of trial environment that companies can use to develop larger or the multi-user and the multiple department solutions. All right, to perform any kind of proof of concepts and all. Now in this type of environment, tenant admin can add a trial subscriptions environment to their environment, or new customers can sign up for a new tenants as well. Okay, so this is the basic difference between these two type of trials. So I'm going to select the trial subscription based, and let's keep the region as India, and I'm just purpose, it's an optional option. And it's automatically created database for the environment. So obviously, if I'm creating an environment, I'm going to create a lot of components inside that. I will create some tables, some columns or the data. All right. So for that, we need obviously a database. So you don't need to bother about the database, how it's being created in the backgrounds and all. So Microsoft will take care of it because it's a cloud instance, right? So it will create a database. Now I will click next. Now once I select next, it will ask me that what you want to keep your URL of your instance. So I can simply say I will simply give the name Arpit Dynamics. Okay. So the URL will be like Arpit Dynamics crm8.dynamics.com. Now, why this? What is the difference between this? CRM8. Why it's taking the name 8? It actually depends on the regions, basically on which region you are creating your trial instance. So I'm actually using or creating a trial from India. That's why it's taking CRM8. I think if you are creating it from the UK region, it will take a CRM 11 or I think CRM 3. I'm not sure about it, but there are different the number based on the region you are creating. For Europe, I guess it's a CRM4.dynamics.com. For India, it's CRM8.dynamics.com. For UK, I think it's CRM11.dynamics.com. So please make sure that you are confirming because I'm not sure whether what is the correct number for the UK and the Euro. So this is basically decide which region you are actually creating. Currency, you can select the currency as well, because there are many features you're gonna use in the environment where you require to choose the currencies and so on, right? So make sure you are selecting the right currency, because once you select the currency, you cannot change it later. So just make sure you are choosing the right currency. Another option is enable Dynamics 365 apps and automatically deploy these apps. So there are two options is there. As I already discussed in my slides, in my earlier videos, that the Dynamics 365 is basically apps-based application nowadays. We don't call it as a modules. We are calling it as an apps, right? So there are a lot of apps are there. So if I go here, there are a lot of apps are there. You can see, the projects operations, the sales pro, and the customer service pros. And so I'm just selecting this yes option so that it will simply create a few applications in my Dynamics 365 trial instance. Security group, I'm just keeping, I'm not selecting as of now because it's actually used to provide the security between two instances. For example, you want that you have a two environments, development and the UAT environment, and you just want to control the access between two environments. For example, the development environment user don't want to create anything in the UAT instance and the vice versa. So this kind of control you can simply access using the security group. So for example, if you have two security groups, security group A and security group B, so if you want that security group A cannot access the controls or the properties of the security group B users, then you can simply handle this. Okay, I'll just go and simply click save. So this will take a few minutes of time to set up my environment. Okay, so I got the message that new environment is getting prepared. It can be used once active. So right now you can see here, I have two environments available, the default and the training environments. All right, so the default environments will automatically get created once you set up your trial instance. Okay, so in my upcoming videos, I'm gonna share the knowledge about what are the different kinds of environments and how many kinds of environment roles are there. But as of now, I'm not focusing on that because it will confuse you. So just remember that once you set up a trial instance, you get the default environments available, and there are some default settings or default user gets created in the environments in the default environment. But I have created my own environments called PowerGuide Training, and you can see here the type of the instance is subscription based, and it is currently being prepared, and the region they created on and everything. If you want to get more details about that, so since it is not prepared yet, otherwise we can simply click on this and get the more details about that. So for example, I just want to view the more details about the environment. I will simply click on that open, or I can simply click on the particular environment, and here you can see more details about that. So I was talking about the roles that a particular environment is having. So environment admin, environment maker. So I'm going to discuss about these type of roles in my upcoming videos. All right, so the resources are Power Apps and the flows and everything. One thing I just wanted to let you know that okay, so you can see here the PowerGuide Training is ready now. So it's been prepared already. Now I can just open it. And you can see the details about that. Now you can see here, there are a lot of details are there related to this particular environment. So in this PowerGuide Training environment, you can see that there are resources available like Dynamics 365 apps. So these apps are nothing but your model driven apps, right? So in my last video, I discussed about the model driven apps. So why we call it as a Dynamics 365 apps, because model driven apps are nothing but, these are the apps which has been created on the Dynamics 365 framework. So Dynamics 365 is the earlier name, and the model driven app is basically the upgraded name of the Dynamics 365, because all the model driven app actually uses the Dynamics 365 layout, whether you are using the sales, whether you are using the field surveys or the marketing app. So all the apps are basically built on top of Dynamics 365 framework, and they are using a common data service. I would not use this term because it has been replaced with the name Microsoft Dataverse. And along with that, you can simply use the Power Apps and the portals and all. So these are the resources you have with your particular environment. Now, so once you set up there, I have seen there are a lot of questions or the issues that users are facing while creating the setting up the trial instance. So there are a few things I just wanted to recommend you that whether if you're setting up the trial instance, there is a troubleshooting startup issues for Power Apps. There is a guide that provided by Microsoft, because there are a lot of users who actually face a lot of issues while setting up the trial instance or the Power Platform, the environment. So there are some common issues like you can get the issues like something went wrong, or you can keep getting this error like sign in required and silent sign in is but no user is signed in kind of issues. You can get this kind of a screen as well. So this is a very common issues that you are actually facing. So this is the issue. You can simply resolve this. If you are using a Microsoft Edge browser, you need to do these kind of browser settings in order to make it work. If you are using Google Chrome, then you simply need to remove few of the cookie settings or create few of the cookie settings. So I'll just provide this URL in my description of this video. So just go and check it out so that you don't face any kind of issues while setting up the trial instance. All right. So in this video, I've actually discussed how you can set up the trial instance. So in my next video, I'm going to show you that how you can simply create the Power Apps. So because our trial instance is ready, now the next video is going to be on the how we can create our first Power Apps and what are the different ways to create the Power Apps. All right, so stay tuned for the next video. Till then, stay safe and bye-bye.